adventure. Here's romance. Here's the famous Robin Hood of the Old West.
Cisco, the sheriff, he's getting closer.
This way, Pancho Barrio.
The Cisco Kid.
What about this business of horses?
Sorry, what was that?
What about this business of horses in the Book of Mormon? Has that raised any problems?
It has, according to some of the archaeological scholars.
We can't get any further until we've taken care of horses then, because this is the main crux. This is the strongest argument, supposedly, that's been raised against the Book of Mormon. What about these horses it's talking about here? What's the objection?
The so-called main crux against the Book of Mormon being the horses argument, saying that, you know, there couldn't have been horses here in the Americas. I think that's an invalid claim. There isn't any mainstream scientists claiming this against the Book of Mormon as the so-called main crux. It's one element of several arguments, but certainly one of the lesser arguments, and I will prove that in my documentation here. Go ahead and check out these scientists and see what they have to say about it.
Well, it was during my my second year as a bishop that I stumbled upon DNA research on Native Americans, and I became quite concerned with what I was reading, because as a plant molecular biologist, I dealt with DNA all the time. I was extracting DNA from plants and cloning genes and sequencing DNA. And I was very familiar with the fundamental technology that was used in these research papers on Native Americans. And I very quickly, over a couple of weeks, discovered that in excess of 99% of Native Americans were clearly descended from Asian ancestors, and knew without a doubt that greater than 99% of Native Americans were undoubtedly related to Siberians and not to the Lamanites.
Was it hard for me to do? It was so easy, because to me, loops, lips, tight, talk naturally. Mom's words seemed like yesterday.
The evidence for elephants is very controversial. It's been usual received opinion that elephants died out quite a few thousand years before the Book of Mormon story begins.
But as it turns out, there are some who still survived on Wrangel Island, which is off the northeastern coast of Siberia. And the latest of them is from 1700 BC, which is well within Jaredite times. Well, that doesn't prove that there were some farther south in the Americas, but we certainly should expect that they could have been.
You know, these issues that they're bringing up with Siberia, the elephants that were there, you know, that all fits into what we know about the Native Americans. We know that, you know, more than 99% of them came from Siberia and Mongolia, and elephants were there as well, as what these Mormon archaeologists are saying. These Mormon scientists are saying that, yeah, there was elephants in Siberia and they may have ventured south. Well, there was also Native Americans in Siberia, which at the time they were Siberians, and they migrated south, but they did not come from Israel. And then you see this bust here of this, you know, so-called Israelite person that was found in Veracruz or in, you know, South America. And they say that represents somebody who is Semitic in origin. But if you look here closely, they're saying that the, you know, bust doesn't represent Native American, because Native Americans don't have facial hair. Well, Mongolians and Siberians do. I mean, look at Genghis Khan here. As far as, you know, beards and facial hair, that bust and this picture of Genghis Khan and, you know, other anthropological elements show that, you know, these these Asians do have facial hair that look very much like that bust. So that can't be a positive on this. That's a false positive, you know. But they keep grasping for straws, trying to figure out, you know, how to prove this stuff. I think that they're off on the wrong track. You know, if you look a little more closely here, you can see what an Israelite looks like compared to their bust. You know what I'm saying? This is an Israelite, and their bust shows someone who's Siberian or Asian, not anything like the Semitic person.
As a Mormon anthropologist, I have a serious problem with the Book of Mormon's representations of American Indians. Not only does it claim that that Lamanites are the principal ancestors of American Indians, but throughout the text, it repeatedly refers to them as Israelites, as descendants of Joseph, of descendants of the biblical patriarchs of Abraham. Those repeated references to an ancient Israelite connection have been clearly invalidated by scientific research into the genes of American Indians. What is most significant about the genetic research and its applicability to the Book of Mormon is that it validates what we already knew from other scientific disciplines. From biological anthropology more generally, we knew a long time ago that American Indians resembled Asians, and particularly the people from the regions around Mongolia and Siberia, more than they did any other peoples. Archaeologically, we knew that there was similarity between the cultures of Northeast Asia and those of the early Americans, that is, in the types of artifacts they used and left behind. We also knew, based upon linguistic evidence, that American Indians shared a common ancestry with at least some of the Northeast Asians and the Siberians. So we had all of this other evidence from scientific disciplines as diverse as linguistics and archaeology and human biology, all showing us an Asian origin of American Indians. Now the genetic data confirms what we already knew from that other material.
All this can be traced in very detailed geographic accounts in Scripture.
So you find maps in the Bible, why don't you find maps in the Book of Mormon?
There's no map showing the Book of Mormon lands because they can't place it on Earth. They don't know where it is.
What about all these illustrated maps you see for the Book of Mormon lands? I mean, why don't they agree with one another? And I guess more important than that, why don't they correspond to any real landmass on Earth?
You can't have a geography because there is no real world setting for the events described in the Book of Mormon. We can't agree upon it because anytime we attempt to try to put it in a real world setting, we have to distort either that real world setting or the text itself. The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints takes no official position on the geography of the Book of Mormon. One of the reasons for this is obvious. Is that the events never took place anywhere.
Mormons believe the Book of Mormon contains the history of ancient civilizations which lived somewhere on the American continents. The introduction to the Book of Mormon says one of those civilizations, called Lamanites, are the principal ancestors of the American Indians. But today, the Church announced it intends to change that introduction. All future copies of the Book of Mormon will say that the Lamanites are among the ancestors of the American Indians. The change is subtle, but important to people who debate the book's authenticity. In recent years, the Church has come under fire by critics who point to a lack of DNA evidence supporting the LDS claims. The change is big news on the internet as well.
Dude, yeah, but I really wanna know. I think you should stop your crying. Here's my kerchief to dry your eyes. You know I love you.